So good afternoon, all of you. Welcome to the second session of our Institutional Ethics Committee lecture. I discarded that another slide, we will go back to that slide another time once we finish with this particular slide, which will more specifically explain about the role and responsibility of the Institutional Ethics Committee. We by far have only 15 people joined. We can wait for 1 minute or so. So we have 20. So let's move on to this particular slide. Let me put it in the slideshow. Yes. So Institutional Ethics Committee, it's an independent body constituted of medical and scientific professionals and non-medical and non-scientific members to ensure the protection of the right and the welfare of the human subjects who are participating in clinical trial, and to provide the public reassurance inter alia by pre-waiving trial protocol, etc. So this is the definition of Institutional Ethics Committee given by WHO. And there might be different names at different institutions. So some of them call it as Independent Ethics Committee, some of them call it as Institutional Review Board, and some of them call it as Institutional Ethics Committee. So, moving on, what is the role of ICC? This is a kind of an introductory slide to Institutional Ethics Committee, but there is no harm in going over the things again. And as we go ahead, because this particular PowerPoint presentation includes more of exposure to the additional duties of Institutional Ethics Committee. Okay, so IEC ensures a competent review of all ethical aspects of project proposal received by it in an objective manner, free from any bias and influence. So that is the most important job. So they have to review the ethical, the particular clinical protocol, which has to be competent enough and which has to be ethical enough, and it should be away from the bias and the influence. Okay. So IECs provide advice to the researchers on all aspects of welfare and safety of research participants after ensuring the scientific soundness. So scientific soundness in the sense that everything will be taken, everything is statistically monitored, everything has the basis or a weightage which will hold a hypothesis true, okay, or at least which will work towards that, proving that hypothesis would be better for the societal use. Okay, so IEC may take up the dual responsibility of review of both the scientific content and the ethical aspect. So this is very important. So in order to scrutinize the scientific content, we have scientific people on the panel. In order to see the ethical aspect, we have non-scientific and non-researcher background people on the committee. So it is advisable to have separate committees for each scientific review proceeds and the scrutiny of for the ethical issues. According, so this is particularly role that has been specified by the ICMR, which is nothing but Indian Council of Medical Research. Then responsibility of IECs. Main responsibility of an IEC can be defined as follows. I think we have seen these 3 points, but still we'll go ahead reading them out. To protect the dignity, rights, and well-being of the potential research participants, to ensure that universal ethical values and international scientific standards are expressed in terms of local community values and customs. So that is the universal ethical values they have to protect, so that everywhere none of the participants is facing injustice in any kind of manner. To assist in the development and the education of the research community responsive to local healthcare requirement. So these are the three main points on which IEC should be focusing according to ICMR. Okay. So they have to do the job of ethical and scientific scrutiny, and also they have to motivate the research community at the same time. Okay. So what are the additional responsibilities that come to IEC? So no clinical trial should be initiated without obtaining a written approval by the IEC. This is the most important statement you should remember, that no clinical trial will be initiated without obtaining a written approval by the IEC. And the IEC should obtain the following documents. We have more or less, we have seen what all documents that IEC should get in order to approve the protocol. So we'll just go through it again. So they should get these many documents from a researcher or an institute who is going to do the clinical trial. So first they should get trial protocol or amendments. Then they should also get written informed consent form and consent form updates that the investigator proposes for use in the trial. Then subject recruitment procedure, for example, advertisements, etc. So yeah, this is also a very important point that I want to tell. So like, how will you tell people that yes, a trial hai, you can participate in this particular? So they have to publicize that particular advertisement into the newspaper and also on the site of ICMR. Okay, so there is a site, there is a particular government site we have only for focusing on clinical trials, which will tell about each and every clinical trial that has happened by far. And how does a clinical trial proceeds? First to everybody, all the researchers and statistician and all the people who are involved in the trial will come together and make a protocol. Once they are ready with the study design and everything, they will get the approval from IEC. Once they get the approval from the IEC, the next job they have to do is recruitment of the subject. How will they recruit the subject? By advertising their particular clinical trial onto the site, official site, and also by advertising into the newspaper. So written, and that is the one thing they have to put it while obtaining the approval as well. Like, you have to approve the advertisement before you publicize it. So who will approve the advertisement for you? IEC will approve the advertisement for you. Then written information to be provided to subject, which will be coming in investigational brochure or the informed consent form. Investigators brochure, we are going to study this particular part in detail. So basically it involves all the details of the drug and what are its effects, what are its side effects, why do you want to, how this particular study of this particular drug will be beneficial for the society or the community. Available safety information about the payments and compensation available to subjects. So this is also most important point that you should be mentioning into the your protocol. Then investigators' current CV and or oblique other documentation evidencing qualification and any other documents that the IEC may need to fulfill its responsibility. So all these documents has to be produced in front of IEC committee before you are, you have to have these all documents ready if you want to get the approval from the IEC. And this is according to the ICH guidelines. Okay. Then the IEC should review a proposed trial within a reasonable time, and the documents its views in writing for the following. ठीक है. सो ऐसा नहीं है कि आईसी कमिटी है तो दे कैन टेक हाउ मच एवर टाइम दे वांट इन ऑर्डर टू स्टडी अ प्रोटोकॉल. जनरली दे आर बीन गिवन अ टाइम ऑफ 3 मंथ्स टू रिव्यू अ प्रोटोकॉल एंड इफ इट्स अ एक्सपेडाइट रिक्वेस्ट देन दे हैव टू डू इट विद इन अ मंथ. ओके, एज सून एज पॉसिबल. So they have to document their views in writing. So whatever they are thinking about the protocol, whatever they are reviewing, they have to write it down on pen and paper, or they have to document it accordingly in black and white. So approval and favorable opinions, whatever they are thinking about the protocol, so whether it could be approval or it could be a favorable opinion, they have to document it. Then modification required prior to its approval and favorable opinion. So if they review your protocol, if they review an institute's clinical trial protocol, and if they think no, the number of subjects they have added is 100, maybe they can go for 120, or some any minute changes they think they should be doing, a researcher or a company should be doing, then they will be telling them beforehand, before they give them a final approval. Then if there is any disapproval or a negative opinion, that also they have to document. And if there is any termination, suspension of any prior approval, favorable opinion. So these all have to be documented by IEC for each protocol they are receiving. Okay, and this is according to the ICH, that is International Community on Harmonization, Conference on Harmonization, sorry. Then additional responsibilities continuing further. IEC should consider qualification of investigator by a current CV or other relevant documentation. Very important. And maine jaise morning ke lecture mein bola tha, investigator has to be a doctor. Okay, if he has to be a doctor in order to make sure that he is running the clinical trial under his guidance. Okay. IEC should conduct the continuing review at interval appropriate to degree of risk. Okay. But at least once per year. Okay. So this is a very important point. So IEC should conduct review at intervals appropriate to the degree of risk. Okay. So agar koi bahut hi critical clinical trial chal raha hai, so it becomes IEC's responsibility to conduct the review at least at intervals. Okay, so just a clinical trial chalu hai, it will go on for say 6 months or something like that, because at a time I cannot review recruit thousands of people and go ahead and do the clinical trial at once. So you do it in the batch. Jaise ek clinical trial facility mein 300 hai, dusre clinical trial facility mein 300 hai, so ek hi trial hai, but it is getting conducted at different places, or it is going to get conducted at one place only at different time phases. Okay, so it is their duty, it is IEC's duty to review the trial at appropriate interval depending on the risk that trial has. Okay, so agar abhi COVID-19 ka trial chal raha hai, if John Hopkins ya phir kaun si bhi big companies are getting involved into doing these trials, so it becomes ethics committee's duty, the most prime duty, to go ahead and review those trials at an interval of 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, or depending on whatever risk. So currently COVID-19 are the most crucial trials that every institute is conducting, every big institute is conducting. So IEC ka yaha pe responsibility sabse zyada badh jata hai, that urge of that hurry, in urge of that influence that we are having, that we have to be there in time, we have to investigate this particular vaccine, we have to do it faster, there should not be any bias, or there should not be any unethical practice that is being conducted, and it has to be scientifically sound. So even after approval, if they have to make sure that everything is going safe and sound. Okay, so the ethical review should be done through formal meetings and should not resort to decision through circulation of the proposal. So this is according to the CDSCO guidelines. I forgot the full form of CDSCO, but I will get back to you with the same. So it should not be circulated in the sense जब भी मीटिंग है तभी ही तुम्हारा जो कुछ भी, जैसे टुडे इज द मीटिंग ऑफ आईसी, आई हैव सबमिटेड माय प्रपोजल, ओके, आईसी विल नॉट टेल मी द डिसीजन देन एंड देयर ओनली, बिकॉज प्रोटोकॉल का डिजाइन, प्रोटोकॉल इन्वेस्टिगेशन, और ये बहुत ही बड़ा फाइल रहता है विच एथिक्स कमिटी हैज टू डू. सो इन द नेक्स्ट मीटिंग, whenever they are done with the review of my particular protocol that I have submitted, they will call me or I'll have to go and see the meeting review personally, in the sense they will be submitting it to me on my personal after meeting me personally, okay. So they cannot circulate the meeting minutes to me just by sending it through email or by paper. The IEC may request more information to be given to subjects when the additional information would add meaningful. So IEC may request more information to be given to subjects when additional information would add meaningfully. In the sense, after reviewing your protocol, if they think that this particular information also should be added in informed consent form, in order to make sure that people are understanding the trial in a much better way, we should go ahead and do that. They should go ahead and do that and add that particular point into the consent or a protocol. Just give me a minute over here. Okay, we can start over. I'm so sorry for that. Next is, when a non-therapeutical trial is to be carried out with the consent of subject's legally acceptable representative, IEC should determine that relevant ethical concerns and applicable regulatory requirements are met. So non-therapeutical trial kya rehta hai abhi? See, if I'm in this COVID-19 pandemic, I'm taking the example of COVID-19 pandemic only, because now we can relate to it in a much better manner right now. Monitoring the mental health of the people who are sitting home for 3 months due to this COVID-19 pandemic. If that is non-therapeutical trial, because I am just going to check for the mental health of a person, right? But it is a clinical trial because I want to conduct it on the people on a major basis. If I enroll, say, 2,000, 3,000 people just by giving them a form, which will just include few amount of questions, and they will just go ahead and fill it up, and we can determine their mental well-being just filling up the form. So in that case also, in this kind of a non-therapeutical trial also, the committee should go ahead and check for the ethical concerns, if there are any, understanding this particular part. If you guys have understood this particular part, please write me so that you guys have understood in the chat box. Have you guys understood this okay. So where prior consent not possible, we are moving on to the next point. Where prior consent is not possible, the IEC should determine the relevant ethical concerns and applicable regulatory requirements are met. That is in emergency situation. ठीक है? Emergency situation कौन सी हो सकती है? जहाँ पे clinical trial consent लेने के लिए भी time नहीं है. In this case, it could be any kind of a emergency surgery, right? जो कभी भी पहले perform नहीं हुए है, and this is a different kind of a approach a doctor has to take before they are going to do the surgery. But then the doctor has to do the all the requirements, means they have to write the protocol and whatever they are going to do in the surgery as well, and get it approved through IEC. I'm just giving you an example what kind of an emergency situation there could be, right? If the person is at a lead, latent stage, in the sense latent stage of a disease, then at that time also it will become like I'm not getting approval from IC because it might take 1 month or so, but I cannot wait that long for my trial to be conducted on that particular patient. It could be, see, if I tell you one particular disease in which the emergency situation can come is could be a cancer, right? Fourth stage cancer, because abhi ye bahut hi zyada spread ho gaya inke liver mein ya fir lung mein. We cannot have do anything, but I have to do a trial and or a error on this person in order to check whether my medicine is going to work or not, right? In that case, they cannot just file a protocol and give it to IEC and wait for them to give the reply, which might take a 1 month or so. In that 1 month of time, that person might die. So that could be an emergency situation in which they have to, IEC should determine the relevant ethical concern and applicable regulatory requirements which are met. Okay, so even if there is no consent that has been signed or taken, then by the person as well, but then still the ethical committee has to go ahead and look for all the regulatory requirements. Then IEC should review both amount and the method of payment to subject to assure that neither presents problem of coercion or under influence on trial subjects. So what they're trying to tell you this through this point is that a person should not just enroll into the trial on the basis of the looking at the monetary benefit they are going to get, right? The amount of method of payment they are going to get. So they should also, like, it should generally that might not happen because a person would enroll for a trial only after looking at the monetary benefit or something like that. But that should not be the only reason for enrolling to the clinical trial. So that is, see, why we are reading all this, another all this responsibility is that along with just scrutinizing one simple protocol which has been submitted by a researcher or an institute, which is very clear ki aisa aisa drug hai, ye aisa aisa disease pe kaam karta hai, it has a minimal side effects, these are its effectiveness, effective characters and etc. And I just want to conduct this trial on 120 people, right? Or whatever will be my subject number. That is a very simple protocol. But all this that what we have read by far, these are all little bit complicated and out of the box studies, right? So for them also, we need different kind of a trial, right? Different kind of a amendment to the proceedings of the IEC committee's approval. Okay, now. So these are also, that's why they are called as additional responsibilities. So if plain protocol approve karna hai, which is a regular protocol, it is the main important duty of the IEC. But at the same time, jo thoda unique studies hai, jo thoda different studies hai, unka bhi protocol approve karna IEC ki responsibility hai. Then IEC should ensure that information regarding payment to subject is set forth in the written informed consent form and any other information to be provided to the subject. The way payment will be prorated should be specified. So in the sense, kitna amount milne wala hai aur wo kaise milne wala hai, that they have to mention in the informed consent form. Jo har ek page wo subject sign karta hai, that they have to mention in the informed. So we are left with only 5 minutes. Can we open the session for any kind of a discussion if anybody wants? I'm unmuting all of you so that you guys can go ahead and ask me any questions if you guys have. It could be anything regarding our academics, or it could be anything regarding by far. If you have any questions, please go ahead and ask me.
Ma'am?
Yes. Yes, Pratibha.
Ma'am, what is IPS?
IPS
full form. It is 13 principles. सब जीसीपी में है मैम.
IPS, I will look into
in accordance with GMP. हाँ, is that Institute of Pharmaceutical Science or anything other? Is it related to some standard or?
No, it is not that. No, it is not.
Okay, ma'am.
I will look into it and I will let you know. Okay.
Oh, okay, ma'am.
Anybody has any other question? Thank you, Pratibha. Anybody has any other question? I hope you guys are okay with having 2 to 3 lectures a day, because that might be our requirement in order to finish our syllabus. Okay. So until the time Pallani ma'am is joining or somebody is joining, we'll have to go ahead and conduct 2 to 3 lectures a day. Okay. So we are going slowly. So last week I did only 1 lecture a day. Now I'll be doing 2 lectures a day. And as slowly we'll proceed so that it's not a burden on you guys as well. Okay. Anybody has any question?
Hello.
Ketan, yes, tell me.
पहला तीन स्लाइड रिपीट करा ना, फर्स्ट 3 स्लाइड.
कोणती ही एडिशनल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज?
हो
नॉन थेरेपिटिक आणि ही सगळी वाली शाल आय रिपीट इट वॉज आय नॉट ऑडिबल इफ आय एम नॉट ऑडिबल इन एनी ऑफ द सेशन्स प्लीज लेट मी नो बिकॉज वी हॅव टू रेकॉर्ड ऑल दिस थिंग ना सो ॲडिशनल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी इन शॉर्ट आय विल जस्ट टेल यू सो नॉन थेरेपिटिक ट्रायल जस्ट आय गेव यू एन एक्झाम्पल ऑफ डूइंग अ ट्रायल ऑन पीपल ड्युरिंग दिस COVID-19 पॅन्डेमिक टू चेक देअर मेंटल वेलबिंग राईट Because people are sitting at home, going crazy, not going out, not going to their work. They are away from their regular life, what they used to live. So that can affect, that can put people into depression, that can that can increase domestic violence. That is what is coming into the news. So if you want to monitor a person's mental well-being, then you will be that is what would be called as a non-therapeutic trial, because it doesn't involve any medication in that. Okay, so in that case also IEC's approval has to be taken. Okay, when prior consent is not possible, in the sense of person is very sick, 60 year old guy, he is into fourth last stage of cancer, to usse consent lena impossible hai. In that case also IEC should determine that relevant ethical concerns and applicable regulatory requirements are followed by a doctor or a researcher who is working on that particular patient. Then IEC should review both amount and the method of the payment, and that should be mentioned into the means like IEC should review means kitna paisa hum log dene wale. Aisa nahi hona chahiye ki researcher ne 30,000, 40,000 bola itna paisa milega, then anybody will enroll for the trial. So it shouldn't be ki zyada paisa de rahe hai iske liye log uske andar enroll ho rahe. So if you give the amount of money which has been calculated, well calculated, which generally comes around to be 18,000 and 20,000, then it becomes IEC's duty to review ki payment method, payment kitna diya ja raha hai aur method of payment kya hai, because subject should not enroll on the basis that I am getting lots of money so I should go and enroll. What does it, how does it matter if I sit for one clinical trial? It's not going to kill me. Then IEC should ensure that information regarding payment to, so informed consent form may, the information about the payment, in the sense how much amount of money a subject is going to get for the clinical trial they are going to sit for, किती पैसे मिळणार आहेत आणि कसे मिळणार आहेत, वेदर दे आर गोइंग टू गेट इन इन द कॅश, वेदर इट विल बी ट्रान्सफर टू देअर अकाउंट, ऑल दॅट हॅज टू बी मेन्शन. ठीक आहे ना? सो दीज आर सम डिफरंट पॉइंट्स विच आयसी हॅज टू लुक इन टू. ओके, अंडरस्टूड?
ओके.
इफ यू स्टील डोंट अंडरस्टँड, वी कॅन ऑलवेज टॉक ऑन द फोन ऑर यू कॅन व्हॉट्सअप. ओके
ओके
ओके. Then I think we are done for this session. There is less than 1 minute. There is less than 1 minute remaining. We can end the session. We'll meet tomorrow at 11:30, and next lecture will be at 1:30, like today. Okay. See you all tomorrow. Bye.